الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. قالوا إن يسرق فقد سرق أخ له من قبل، فأسرها يوسف في نفسه ولم يبدها لهم، قال أنتم شر مكانا، والله أعلم بما تصفون. قالوا يا أيها العزيز إن له أبا شيخا كبيرا، فخذ أحدنا مكانه، إنا نراك من المحسنين. قال معاذ الله أن نأخذ إلا من وجدنا متاعنا عنده إنا، قال معاذ الله أن نأخذ إلا من وجدنا متاعنا عنده إنا إذا لظالمون. فلما استيأسوا منه خلصوا نجيا، قال كبيرهم ألم تعلموا أن أباكم قد أخذ عليكم موثقا من الله ومن قبل ما فرطتم في يوسف، فلن أبرح الأرض حتى يأذن لي أبي أو يحكم الله لي، وهو خير الحاكمين. ارجعوا إلى أبيكم فقولوا يا أبانا، فقولوا يا أبانا إن ابنك سرق، وما شهدنا إلا بما علمنا، وما كنا للغيب حافظين. واسأل القرية التي كنا فيها والعير التي أقبلنا فيها، وإنا لصادقون. قال بل سولت لكم أنفسكم أمرا، فصبر جميل، عسى الله أن يأتيني بهم جميعا، إنه هو العليم الحكيم. وتولى عنهم وقال يا أسفا على يوسف وبيضت عيناه من الحزن فهو كظيم. قالوا تالله تفتأ تذكر يوسف حتى تكون حرضا أو تكون من الهالكين. قال إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله، وأعلم من الله ما لا تعلمون. يا بني اذهبوا فتحسسوا من يوسف وأخيه، ولا تيأسوا من روح الله، إنه لا ييأس من روح الله إلا القوم الكافرون. فلما دخلوا عليه قالوا يا أيها العزيز مسنا وأهلنا الضر وجئنا ببضاعة مزجاة فأوف لنا الكيل وتصدق علينا، إن الله يجزي المتصدقين. قال هل علمتم ما فعلتم بيوسف وأخيه إذ أنتم جاهلون؟ قالوا أئنك لأنت يوسف؟ قال أنا يوسف وهذا أخي قد من الله علينا إنه من يتق ويصبر فإن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين. قالوا تالله لقد آثرك الله علينا وإن كنا لخاطئين. قال لا تثريب عليكم اليوم يغفر الله لكم وهو أرحم الراحمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear brothers, Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord who has given us the capability to wake up and remember Him. And Alhamdulillah, when you woke up this morning, probably you have recited the dua, Alhamdulillah, الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور. And then you made your wudu, and Alhamdulillah, you made your way to the masjid. And here we are, Alhamdulillah, where we have just prayed Salatul Fajr in congregation. And Alhamdulillah, we are still traveling through Surah Yusuf. And if you can remember yesterday's recitation, or the portion that we have recited yesterday, we started from وَجَاءَ إِخْوَةُ يُوسُفَ فَدَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ فَعَرَفَهُمْ وَهُمْ لَهُ مُنْكِرُونَ, that the brothers of Yusuf came. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said وَجَاءَ إِخْوَةُ يُوسُفَ فَدَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ, and they entered upon him. فَعَرَفَهُمْ, he recognized them. وَهُمْ لَهُ مُنْكِرُونَ, while they were oblivious to him. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in those very few words, has captured a whole scene. Just imagine what brought them to Egypt. We said the reason that they went to Egypt is because the hardship has also been felt in Sham. And their father, Ya'qub alayhi salam, has said to them, go to Egypt and get some food for us. And also what we can learn from that ayah is that Yusuf alayhi salam, he was not only macro-managing the whole system, but he was also doing micro-managing. Subhanallah. How come that he was able to speak to people like individuals when they come to buy food from him, or they come to buy food from the government? He was able to see them, talk to them by person, and sometimes ask them questions and so forth. And that's how he came to know that they actually had 11 brothers. There were 11 brothers instead of only 10 brothers. And there are many other things that we can read into that passage. But inshallah ta'ala, because of the time, we won't be able to do that. But hopefully a day is going to come when we're going to do an in-depth study of the surah, inshallah ta'ala. This morning, we have started from قَالُوا إِن يَسْرِقْ فَقَدْ سَرَقَ أَخُ لَهُ. Fast forward it a little bit. Yesterday, when the cup was found in the bag of Yusuf's brother Binyamin, the judgment, or what the brothers have said, was قَالُوا إِن يَسْرِقْ فَقَدْ سَرَقَ أَخُ لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ. They said, if Binyamin has committed a theft, he had a brother who used to also steal. قَالُوا إِن يَسْرِقْ فَقَدْ سَرَقَ أَخُ لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ. Just imagine, they were disassociating themselves from Binyamin. They were saying, like, he's not from our side of the family. So they were pushing away Binyamin and his brother Yusuf alayhi salam. And Yusuf alayhi salam, he's the one who's listening to this. These guys, they were the guys who have abused him. And right now, they had the audacity, although they didn't know, they had the audacity to still go after Yusuf, even though they don't know whether he's alive or dead. And the ulama, they said, what we can learn from this as well is that those people who have jealousy in their heart, that jealousy is difficult to be removed from the heart. Can you believe these brothers, after that long, just after that length of time, they have still they have not been able to get rid of the jealousy that they had towards Yusuf alayhi salam. قَالُوا إِنْ يَسْرِقْ فَقَدْ سَرَقَ أَخُ لَهُ. Just imagine the volcano that was almost about to erupt inside the chest of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, but still he was holding it down. SubhanAllah. فَأَسَرَّهَا يُوسُفُ فِي نَفْسِهِ وَلَمْ يُبْدِهَا لَهُمْ. SubhanAllah. They were probably accusing, like, because they said, like, his brother Benjamin stole, and Yusuf alayhi salam has also stole before something. And probably they're attributing this to their mother. They're saying, like, we are from a pure side of the family, because they all had the same mother. But Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam and Benjamin, they had the same mother. So, like, they're saying, they're not from us. Okay, they're different. So, فَأَسَرَّهَا يُوسُفُ فِي نَفْسِهِ وَلَمْ يُبْدِهَا لَهُمْ. And then the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us. They said, قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزِ إِنَّ لَهُ أَبًا شَيْخًا كَبِيرًا فَخُذْ أَحَدَنَا مَكَانَهُ. Now they want a sweet talk to Yusuf alayhi salam, but they don't know him. يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزِ. Okay, يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزِ إِنَّ لَهُ أَبًا شَيْخًا كَبِيرًا. They brought their father into the equation. They said, he has a father who's really old. So they knew that Yusuf alayhi salam, or the minister, they knew that he was a kind person, he was just, he was mashallah, someone who was helpful. So they thought maybe if they brought in the father and they try and manipulate Yusuf's thoughts or feelings, they said, Ya ayyuhal aziz, inna lahu aban shaykhin kabiran, fakhud ahadana makanahu. Take someone in his place as a collateral and let him go, so his father doesn't feel very sad if he doesn't come with us. Look at Yusuf alayhi salam in the next ayah. قَالَ مَعَهَذَ اللَّهُ. The Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, he's clinging onto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ مَعَهَذَ اللَّهُ. He said, no way. قَالَ مَعَهَذَ اللَّهُ. Why? قَالَ مَعَهَذَ اللَّهِ أَن نَأْخُذَ. Look at the words he used. أَن نَأْخُذَ إِلَّا مَنْ وَجَدَنَا مَتَعَنَا عِنْدَهُ. He didn't say, we will not take anyone who has not stolen anything. He said, we will only take the person, he said, قَالَ مَعَذَ اللَّهِ أَن نَأْخُذَ إِلَّا مَنْ وَجَدَنَا مَتَعَنَا عِنْدَهُ. We will only take the person that we found our things with. He didn't say the person who stole, because he knows his brother did not steal anything. It was placed in there. He said, قَالَ مَعَذَ اللَّهِ أَن نَأْخُذَ إِلَّا مَنْ وَجَدَنَا مَتَعَنَا عِنْدَهُ. SubhanAllah. إِنَّا إِذَا لَظَالِمُونَ. And why is Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam seeking help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though he's in position of power? He's like saying, I don't want to abuse the power that I have. When was the other time Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam said, Ma'adallah? When he was what? When he was invited to do the haram. What did he say? Qala Ma'adallah. That time, innahu rabbi ahsana mathwaya. He repeated the same thing. Now he's saying, I am also seeking the help of Allah right now. Even though I'm in a position of power, I don't want my power to corrupt me. SubhanAllah. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, he's clinging on and hanging on to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's seeking assistance from Allah in both times, when he was weak and when he's powerful. Remember that. Another important lesson we can take from this ayah, قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ. What Yusuf alayhi salam is doing right now, imagine Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, he is a minister in a government or a kingdom that everyone else is a non-Muslim. He's giving them da'wah indirectly. He's mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They can hear it. SubhanAllah. And he's not afraid to do so. Some of us, some of our Muslims today, if they work in a particular company or somewhere, they don't even want to mention their name correctly. They would say, what? Yeah, Mo. I don't know, what's your Mo? He's scared to say, I am Muhammad. Okay? Or he will not say to his fellow Muslim brothers, Assalamu alaikum. Say hi, good morning. Ya akhi, I'm your Muslim brother. Do you know? Can you recognize me? Say salam alaikum rahmatullah. Why are you scared? What are you afraid of? Look, Yusuf alayhi salam, he's probably the only person who was a Muslim at that time. And he is not afraid to say ma'ad Allah, to bring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into the equation whenever he gets the opportunity. Qala ma'ad Allah. He's saying, as if he's saying to his people, guys, where do I get this strength, or where do I get the moral, the ethics that I have? I am getting them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qala ma'ad Allah. SubhanAllah. That's another important lesson. And the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَمَّا اسْتَيْأَسُوا مِنْهُ خَلَصُوا نَجِيًّا. SubhanAllah. The next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, now the brothers, they tried to convince Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam to let Benjamin go. But when they have not been able to do so, and they felt, خلاص, there's no chance that we can convince Yusuf to let, or Al-Aziz, to let go and Benjamin, what's going to happen? خَلَصُوا نَجِيًّا. Now they are going to have a private meeting among themselves, the brothers, Why do you think they want to have a private meeting? They don't want anybody from Egypt to hear what they're about to say to each other. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has narrated part of the conversation of what has taken place at the time of that meeting. And probably this could be the end of the conversation. Imagine what the older brother said. Allah said, قَالَ كَبِيرُهُمْ أَلَمْ تَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ أَبَاكُمْ أَلَمْ تَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ أَبَاكُمْ قَدْ أَخَذَ عَلَيْكُمْ مَوْثِقًا مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَمِنْ قَبْلُ مَا فَرَّدْتُمْ فِي يُوسُفَ. It is as if what has ensued before this moment was like maybe some of the brothers, they forgot, or they did not take seriously the covenant that they've made with their father. So maybe some of them, they said, what can we do anyway? Let's go back. We have good excuse. And he was the one who stole. It's not our fault. It's his fault. Let's go. But the eldest one said, guys, alam ta'alamu, guys, did you forget? He didn't say, did you forget? He said, do you not know the covenant that we took with our father regarding Yusuf? So he reminded them, alam ta'alamu, anna abakum qad akhadha alaykum mawthiqan min Allah, wa min qablu ma farratum. And now he reminded them, and what you did to Yusuf before. Imagine if anybody from Egypt heard them talking about this issue, Yusuf, and then what they did to the younger brother. Okay? They didn't want anybody to hear this. Khalasu najiyya. Allah said, they went into a private place and they started discussing with one another, what shall we do? Where do we go from here? And then the Kabir, the eldest one, okay, Rubil, his name, or some of the ulama that said his name is Yehuda. He was the eldest one, or he was the wisest one. قَالَ كَبِيرُهُمْ أَلَمْ تَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ أَبَاكُمْ قَدْ أَخَذَ عَلَيْكُمْ مَوْثِقًا مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَمِنْ قَبْلُ مَا فَرَّتُمْ فِيهِ. And then he said, فَلَنْ أَبْرَحَ الْأَرْضَ حَتَّى يَأْذَنَ لِي أَبِي أَوْ يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ لِي. It seems like this brother has realized, you know, what he did to his father. And now he feels like so ashamed. He doesn't want to stand in front of his father. Probably he was the one who convinced the father to let go of Binyamin. Let Binyamin go with his brothers. So he's like saying, how can I ever stand before my father and say to him, we have not got Binyamin with us? And probably he was the one who convinced his father at the beginning when Yusuf was taken away. SubhanAllah, he said, I'm not going to go back. فَلَنْ أَبْرَحَ الْأَرْضَ. I'm going to stay in Egypt until my father gives me the permission to go back. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings down a judgment. أَوْ يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ لِي وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. I'm not going to go back. So what else has he said to his brothers? Irji'u ila abikum. You guys, the rest of you, go back to your father. Irji'u ila abikum. And say to them, فَقُولُوا يَا أَبَانَا إِنَّ مْنَكَ. Our father, your son. Ah, they want to shift the blame from themselves. They've got nothing to do with this issue. يَا أَبَانَا إِنَّ مْنَكَ. Your son, you know that son that you used to like? Binyamin. إِنَّ مْنَكَ سَرَقَ. He stole. He committed an act of theft. إِنَّ مْنَكَ سَرَقْ وَمَا شَهِدْنَا إِلَّا بِمَا عَلِمْنَا. And we only bear witness to what we've seen. Okay, we saw the item being taken out from his box or from his bag. وَمَا شَهِدْنَا إِلَّا بِمَا عَلِمْنَا وَمَا كُنَّا لِلْغَيْبِ حَافِظِينَ. And we did not know from the unseen what happened behind our backs, what he did. We weren't prepared for this one. وَمَا كُنَّا لِلْغَيْبِ حَافِظِينَ. Some of the ulama said, الغيب is the night itself. We don't know what he did during the night. وَمَا كُنَّا لِلْغَيْبِ حَافِظِينَ. And now they have other witnesses. So they said to their father, وَاسْأَلِ الْقَرْيَةَ الَّتِي كُنَّا فِيهَا وَالْعِيرَ الَّتِي أَقْبَلْنَا. They said, you can ask the village or the town that this has happened, you know, where this incident has happened. The people of that town, you can go and ask them. So meaning like go to Egypt and find out the truth for yourself. Because they know probably their father is going to suspect them of lying. So, وَالْعِيرَ الَّتِي أَقْبَلْنَا. They also saw the caravan that we were with. They were not by themselves. They had other people with them. And indeed we are telling the truth. And Yusuf, his father Yaqub alayhi salam, said, قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. He said, Yaqub alayhi salam, and the father said, your souls have prompted you to do wrong. قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. He used the same, subhanallah, statement like he used when he lost Yusuf alayhi salam. He said, فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ, a beautiful sabr. That's all I have got. I'm going to be patient. But this time, what is he going to say? عَسَى اللَّهُ أَن يَأْتِيَنِي بِهِمْ جَمِيعًا. May God bring all of them back to me. He hopes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring all of them back to him. He has that hope. Now, how many children is he missing, Prophet Yaqub? three. How? He's missing Yusuf. He's missing Binyamin. And the eldest who gave up, who said, I'm not going back. Three of his sons are missing now. Subhanallah. Look at the test. Maybe some of you have been asking yourself this question. Why is Yusuf alayhi salam doing this to his father? Now he's powerful. Now he's got everything. Why didn't he just reveal himself to his brothers and say, guys, I'm Yusuf. Bring the family. Why is Yusuf doing what he's doing? That's a good one. They might not tell the father. Another reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ulama said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam to do this. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to test Ya'qub further. Subhanallah. This is from the hikmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, Prophet Yusuf, he is a prophet. He gets wahy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is Prophet Yusuf doing what he's doing? Like the plan, the plot, everything. The scheming and everything. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to do so. So Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, he knows what he's doing. He said, and Prophet Ya'qub alayhi salam said, Innahu huwa al-alim al-hakim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one who knows everything. And he's the one who's all wise. وتولى عنهم. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, right now he turned away from them. وتولى عنهم. وقال يا أسف على يوسف وبيضت عيناه. He said, my grief and for Yusuf, and he lost his eyesight. His eyes went white. وبيضت عيناه من الحزن, because of the sorrow that he was feeling. فهو كظيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, and he was filled with sorrow. And what did they say to him? قالوا تالله تفتأ تذكر يوسف حتى تكون حرضا أو تكون من الهالكين. They said, by Allah, you will never cease remembering Yusuf. Because always you are mentioning Yusuf alayhi salam. Until you become weak with old age, or until you be of the dead, or until you die. And this is the last statement. Subhanallah, look at how powerful this statement is. قال إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله والله أعلم. Wallahu wa'alamu min Allah ma la ta'alamun. He said, I only complain of my grief and sorrow to Allah, and I know from Allah that which you know not. This is exactly the same statement Aisha radiallahu anha has said when she was accused of committing the fornication or the zina. Aisha, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam spoke to her, and her father was there, Abu Bakr radiallahu anha, and her mother was sat in the room, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to her, Aisha, if you committed this sin, just admit it and make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Aisha radiallahu anha has said something really powerful. She said, if I tell the truth, you're not going to believe me. If I lie to you, you will believe me. And she said, all I can say is, إِنَّمَا أَشْكُوا بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَعْلَمُ. She said, I wanted to quote what Yusuf's father has said. And Aisha radiallahu anha, at that particular moment, she said, I did not memorize a lot of the Quran. Can you believe she was the wife of the Prophet ﷺ? She was young. And she said, I did not memorize much of the Quran. And I tried to figure out the name of Yusuf's father. And she quoted the ayah, إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو. She said to the Prophet ﷺ and her father and her mother, إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَعْلَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. When she said that, she just lied down. She said, خلاص, this is all I can say. I only complain of my grief and sorrow to Allah, and I know from Allah that which you know not. قالت إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله. Prophet Yusuf, Prophet Yaqub عليه السلام, he's gonna say to his sons, go and look for Prophet Yusuf. What will happen and transpire, don't miss tomorrow. بارك الله فيكم, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.